good morning and welcome to all of you. I was reminded of a story which I had heard in my childhood and which has left a deep impact on me. There was a young man who came from a very rich family. His family was stinking rich. They had enough wealth to last next five generations. Anyway, he was sent to school and college. He finished his education. And then he said, now what do I do? I don't need to go and take a job somewhere. I can join the family business, but then I'll be earning more money for my family, and my family has more than enough money. So why don't I do some social work? Why don't I give back to society rather than, you know, trying to earn more money? There's no need for money. So I'd rather do something worthwhile and I'd rather give to society. God has been so kind to me that I'm born in such a good family. Now, how do you go about doing that? So he was wondering, you know, how do I go about doing it? Somebody told him that on the top of Himalayas, there is an old sadhu, a Swamiji, who is the wisest man in the whole world. He doesn't give discourses, he doesn't bother about anybody, he's sitting over there. But he is a person who can really give you wisdom if you want. Fine. Young man went climbing on top of the Himalayas, landed up over there, and found that Swamiji sitting alone, went and touched his feet and said, Guruji, I want to learn the wisdom of the world from you. He said, what for? He said, I want to change the whole world. I am young, I am energetic, I am educated, I have got enough financial resources. I want to do something for the world. You don't know, sitting over here, what's happening down there? It's all corruption and terrorism and this and that. I want to bring about a change in the world. Swamiji smiled and said, yes, I'll tell you how to go about it. I have only one condition. Yes, any condition. He said, my condition is you come back after 20 years. What? I'm young, energetic, enthusiastic. I want to start today. And you're saying 20 years. He said, I told you, no, one condition and you agreed. Go back. Very disappointed, he came back. He thought maybe he doesn't want to teach me, so he's obviously sent me off. Life continued. He was looking after his family business, doing whatever it is. 20 years went past. He was feeling very restless. Is this all that life is all about? Just earning more and more money, doing this, doing that. So at one point, he remembered that 20 years have gone past. Let me go back and ask him now. So 40-year-old man with difficulty climbed all over, right up to the top of Himalayas, and found the same Swamiji sitting there in the same place. He went and touched his feet and said, do you remember me? He said, yes, I remember you. Why have you come? He said, you had asked me to come back after 20 years. You said you'll teach me the wisdom of the world. He said, fine, yes, I will definitely do that. I just want to know why you want to learn the wisdom of the world. He said, see, at that time, if you had given it to me, I was willing to travel all over the world, bring about changes, do wonders, because I was so young and fit and smart. Today I'm a middle-aged man, I have my limitations, so I'm going to be frank with you. Whatever you're going to teach me, I'm going to just, you know, spread the word among my own area, in my own city, and among my own known people and all that. That's all I can do. That's why I want to learn. Swamiji said, I have still one condition. Now what's the condition? Come back after 20 years. This time he got very angry and he said, old man is unnecessarily trying to play games with me. To hell with him, and he came back. 20 years went past. 60-year-old man now. What am I doing in life? I've earned crores and crores of rupees. I'm getting old and this and that. And is my life just going to end like this? Last ditch he remembered. Okay, he had said 20 years. No, I'm 60 now. I'll go. With great difficulty, 60-year-old man climbed all the way to the top of the Himalayas. Found our Swamiji still sitting there in the same position. Went and touched his feet and said, do you remember me? Of course I remember you. I've come to learn the wisdom of the world. I hope this time you're not going to send me away. He said, yes, my son, I will teach you. Tell me why you want. He said, see, I'm being very frank with you. I'm now 60 years old. I'm retired. Nobody cares for me now. Even if I go into my community or my neighborhood and tell something, they say old man has nothing better to do, so that's why he is doing this. Children have grown up and gone away. I can't even change them now. My wife has stopped listening to me long back, so I can't change her. Finally, all I can do possibly is bring about some change in my own life for my last sunset years. Swamiji said, sit down. Now that you have learned the basic rule of life, that you can't change anybody, you can only change yourself, now you are ready to learn the wisdom of the world. I will take you forward from